Boy, this my court, got a block on lock.
I made it by the million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. And shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Hit the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it.
They don't know my name. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade. Tie me up in chains. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
They say fall and you let go, but I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smile, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables. Yeah, look at me, at the asylum. Was a fate or mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yeah, the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want in my head, come and call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes where you walk your pugs. In a time you could rate where there ain't no love.
Where do I go?
Reflux, I drip out from the socket to a teacup. Drink up inside, look when they beep us. Jesus in the belly of the beast, but outside there's a war going on your front lawn. Black Hawk, see the red dawn horizon. Blind yet I'm rising, abiding by laws of attraction. My thoughts still rising, thinking. What type of knowledge gon' sink in? Life gives you lemons, and my only thought is drinking. Thirsty, will I be alive or dead before 30? That's all that concerns me early. Lemonade quenching my inner rage when it takes center stage, way before they pouring on my grave. Minute made, let it set my soul ablaze on each and every way. Put me in the water for the save.
They don't know my name. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade. Tie me up in chains. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade. They don't know my name. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
Lemonade, lemonade.
Tie me up in chains.
Ah.
irresponsible without your money, I'm not. Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And now we spin the block around just like the hand on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money, I'm not. Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hands on the clock.
Come like a bat out of the hell, I dare you to cross like a reverend. And my energy paralyzed, I'm like a finger 11. Take a second, I'm finna send it like a parent. A message to the best. If it ain't me, then you need you a confession. You a mess. You ain't scary to me. Heard you was the leader, but that ain't apparent to me. Put dust on you like cheetah, run up and I'm air in the scene. And I feel just like Vegeta Prince, and I'm an heir to the seat.
I mean, for real. Test the driver's saw so I don't even grab the wheel. That's it on my chest, but it don't mean a man is stealing. Man, I'm walking with some money, man, I mean a couple mil. Ew, think you need a mail. You ain't even eating while I'm feasting in the field. That's why I'm always cheesing, cause I feel like Uncle Phil. And all this loose think the freshman ain't half the man as well. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hand on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hands on the clock.
Just like the hands on the clock, I go back to bat when I'm doing numbers. All the mad that I'm driving the bus, so they threw me under. Heard they mad, they don't want to bust. So they boo each other, think that they're the winning team, go losing, then they choose another. And that's okay, cause I'm competing with me, not you. I live with blessings like I can't stop sneezing, not you.
I hate to break a bone, me and myself top two. I blow away the competition like a bowl of hot soup. And there's no catch. I go and get the bag and I'm not bringing it back. I'm like a down QB. I put the pain in the past. And if you ever had a problem, promise I didn't ask. So it's 444 in the car, my dash. I shake a pick, told them all you went first, you last. Little boy, that's facts. I'ma grow that cash to my money. You know what? Let me stop.
Me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top of it. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of. I got both my girls head to toe designer. Drip, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. I can't hear the hate, got a lot of it. Take these bands to the bank, let them rot in it. So much ice on me, I wish I had two necks. I got homies that can sleep without two. I got homies that can sleep without. Gucci and Chanel, I got a lot of it. Walk up in the spot like, hey, what poppin' in? Come pop it for me, cause I'm rich and poppin' in. Yeah. Drip, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. She gon' put it on me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top of it. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of. I got both my girls head to toe, designer. Drip, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. West LA, that where you find me though. Cha-cha macha with a rockin' black clothes. Whip around that Batmobile, duckin' 5-0. If you step to me, then be prepared for smoke, little bro. Let me fill myself a little bit. Let me blow this down a little bit. Drip, little bit. Let me fill myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium. The two teams emerging from their respective tunnels a minute ago to the approval of this Baltimore crowd. They're all set as their Ravens will match up with the Arizona Cardinals.
Gonzalez to kick off for Arizona.
Here's the kicker, Zane Gonzalez, ready to get this one started. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium.
Now this will make it into the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
First and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Now a play fake here on first down. Buying time to his left. He's going to take off with it. The game's first play produces 6 yards. Brings up second down.
Well, you know, paramount for this defense is trying to keep Lamar Jackson somewhat contained when he tries to run. They did a pretty good job of it there.
And you know what's so difficult for every defense has to prepare for Lamar Jackson? You have to think and play at the same time. And I know that sounds like something you're supposed to do. But when you have to think about your assignments against him, it often slows down your feet. You don't move as fast. You've got to be prepared for this guy every step of the way and then try and match his athleticism.
That's a gain of 3.
That's some good tackling there to keep him short of that yellow line.
Yeah, defensively, all I'm thinking is that on that play, get me to third down. Get me into a position where I can make one more play and get my defense off the field.
Now on third down, that pass knocked down in the backfield and incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
This one now in their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. They're running Ingram, and he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert.
First and 10 at the 30-yard line.
The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Throwing is Jackson. They go screen. This is Ingram. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2.
Complete to Mark Ingram.
And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved. Just as you said, they want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Here's Jackson. He's going deep for Brown. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Marquise Brown, 62 yards. And the Ravens have taken the early lead. Not a bad way to start it.
And I think that that was part of their script, because so many teams script their opening possessions. And whether it's just that possession or even deeper into the half, sometimes it's 15 to 30 plays. That had to be one in there where they call a shot play. Go for the big one, and they got it done.
Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he returns this to the 22.
The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 22. And from the shotgun, he'll throw. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. The Pro Bowler DeAndre Hopkins, the intended receiver. But it'll be second down.
22-yard line.
So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. Throwing again, Murray. And incomplete on the deep ball. DeAndre Hopkins once again the intended target. Third down here.
So many times we see teams go on the road and want to lean on their running game, but this crew just announced they're going to try and air it out and make hay downfield.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. And he goes down. The Ravens able to get to him. Like a freight train off the edge, Calais Campbell with a sack. Well, they went with the nickel. They throw in an extra defensive back. Coverage was very good.
Yeah, it was exactly as you would expect. A passing down, you bring in the nickel package. Just as you described, the coverage was excellent and allowed one of their linemen to end up getting to the quarterback.
And he'll get credit for a punt inside the 20. Not by much, but inside the 20 at the 19-yard line.
They're on 19-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say when you're running the big-time races. It means they get out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now.
And it drops down incomplete.
Coverage by
Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down. This will be a short gain of three before he's brought down at the 22.
The ball carrier.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in the expected passing situation.
On third down, Jackson. And looking for Andrews, but this is intercepted. Devondre Campbell, the linebacker, picks it, and he will score. Touchdown, Cardinals.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7.
You know what's coming. Zane Gonzalez to kick off for Arizona.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Returning it, Justice Hill. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line.
The Ravens take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. They'll run with Ingram here to begin the drive. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Tackle made there by Jordan Hicks.
No gain.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. From the gun, Jackson. That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end. And they finally get him, but not before he reaches the 33-yard line. A big play that time for the Ravens. 47 yards. Flushed out right. And he's going to keep it here. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Under pressure and he'll go down. They'll sack him on what ought to be the final play of this first quarter. These two teams all tied after one. Now they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. From the gun, it's Jackson. Jackson hit, and he lost the football. And the Cardinals have got it, going the other way. And now off to the races, down the right side. And they bring this one back. A scoop and score, a fumble recovery, touchdown for Arizona. Oh, backbreaker. That'll drive the coach, the offensive coordinator, just crazy. You get it all the way down there in the red zone, can't capitalize. Instead, they go the other way on the fumble return for a touchdown.
How about the aggressiveness of the defense, though? They're not about to just fall on a fumble, are they? Scoop and score is their motto, and they just did it.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return.
Fielded in the end zone. And Hill will opt for the touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And they'll be looking to start fresh. Just a moment ago, they were backed up, coughed up the football, and then saw it go the other way for 6 points.
I just wonder, partner, sometimes they put such an emphasis on things. And, you know, in that situation, as they ran out there, they were told, take care of the football, don't cough it up. And sometimes that's the last thing you hear, and that's exactly what you do.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. Now a handoff to Ingram. He can muster only a yard there, and they'll be left with a third and very short.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
Third and inches, and they've got some extra beef up front. Three tight ends.
There may have been a little bit of an element of surprise there. Third and inches, and they go quarterback sneak. I still feel like this is a play that often is reserved for fourth down.
5-yard line.
This time Jackson will throw it. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 12 yards the pick up there. Good for a Raven first.
That is definitely what we call our defense an uh-oh play. And what you mean by that is against Lamar Jackson. When you see him out of the pocket, your first thought is, uh-oh, he's going to try and run it. How do I get to him and get him on the ground? And guess what? That didn't happen, and his receivers took advantage.
Now there's a quick throw caught by Andrews. And he'll take this from 147-yard line to the other. A gain of six. His second catch. This one not quite as dynamic as his first. And it's second down. On Second down and four. Jackson looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. Marquise Brown was the intended target, and it's third down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
The Ravens on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and four. They'll run with a rookie second rounder. It's J.K. Dobbins. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. Third down turns to first with that 5-yard pickup. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter. 14-7. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A 2-minute drill before the coach's 2-minute drill.
And he's taken down inside the 30. They get 14 on that one. That's good for a Baltimore first down.
First and 10 at the 28.
They'll fake the give to Ingram. Now Jackson. His throw caught right around the 6. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6.
That's another
23 yards on the play. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. They'll run with Dobbins, and he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. Jackson from the shotgun. Got a man, it's caught for a Ravens touchdown. J.K. Dobbins there to make the grab. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14.
That ties the game at 14. Justin Tucker to kick.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. That's the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
Take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. Tie ball game, still a little more than a minute to go in the half. The question, can they put something together here, try to take that lead into intermission? And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes. Calais Campbell picks up his second sack of the afternoon. After the sack on first down, Murray. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line.
You can easily see the logic. It's a tie game. They just wanted to press it a little bit right before the half, hoping to get one more score.
Now, easy to second-guess the result, but now you have to think after that interception, just a field goal, and they're behind at the break.
Yeah, I think at the half, the head coach just says, look, that's on me. I wanted to press it, but it's because I believe in you guys.
This is Ingram on first and 10. Down to about the 22 here. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts. As the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. A good run, got 7 on first. Here's second and 3. Operating from the gun, Jackson. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. Back of the end zone, could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
He's got the first down inside the 10, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. J.K. Dobbins with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Ravens have broken the tie. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14.
Makes the score Ravens 21, Cardinals.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense.
Inside of a minute left in the half, does the fact that you're down on the scoreboard influence what you do?
And Murray in trouble here, and down he goes. Calais Campbell able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon. To try again after the sack. Murray, and the pressure gets to him again. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter.
And it's third down.
Well, that last sack puts Murray and the Cards in a tough spot, third and long. Not wanting to risk another sack, they'll play it safe with a run. And they'll indeed stop him on third down. And now what do you want to do with your timeouts? So we've hit
Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
It'll be the Cardinals who get the ball first. They trail here as we resume action in the third quarter. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And this will be a touchback. No return from Isabella. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. From the gun, Murray. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Well, CD, you know, taking a step back, we're 2 weeks into the season, and you already kind of get the sense the teams are beginning to separate themselves. If you look at the 2-0 teams, and remember, 62% of 2-0 teams ultimately make the playoffs, but Baltimore, Kansas City, Green Bay, Seattle, just to name a few, they look really good.
They certainly do, and in a lot of ways, those are the teams that we expected to be 2-0 at this part of the season. I mean, it's no major surprise. How about Arizona being 2-0 as well? People talked about them getting better in the offseason. I don't know how many of us thought they'd beat San Francisco in the opener. They did. Then they jumped on Washington this week, and they are 2-0 as well.
Now, on the other side of the spectrum, we know the not good news about teams that start 0-2. The Giants and the Jets both there, Detroit, Cincinnati. So, again, maybe some more predictable names.
Certainly, they are predictable. Again, not a surprise for most of them, although many thought Detroit would be improved at this point. But how about a team that's 0-2 that went through?
He's got it! Hit the 15! And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. DeAndre Hopkins, 47 yards. And the Cardinals are just an extra point away from tying this game. He's got it, and we're all tied at 21.
That ties the game at 21 apiece. Zane Gonzalez to kick off for Arizona.
So all square here in this third quarter as the kick's away. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now, first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Off of play action, he'll look to throw. Open man is the tight end, Nick Boyle. And he gets this down deep inside of Arizona's 15-yard line. It's a big play there for Baltimore. 48 yards.
At the 11-yard line.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. Here's Jackson to throw. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Different story this time around. We had that huge gain followed by a sizable loss here.
It's interesting, partner, that most defenses try and guard the 35-yard line actively because they think the way kickers are nowadays, about a 52-yard field goal, they're kind of giving up points. But you get even deeper into territory, you get into the red zone, they're going to guard it even more, which means more pressure, more blitzing.
So following the sack, they'll try to change their fortune here on second and 13. And this play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back to the 15. Just a loss of a yard there, but it's not going to help. Now they face a third and 14.
Third and 14.
Couple of plays sent them the wrong way, and now they face a third and 14. From the gun, Jackson toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
So on fourth down, here's the Ravens Pro Bowl kicker Justin Tucker out onto the field. And that is no good. And we will remain tied here in this third quarter. Boy, you sure don't see that too often.
I guess you can't really call anything a gimme, but you figure with his track record, that's a sure thing. But it turns out, it's not the case.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Well, let's go back to the start of the season talk, Charles. We talked about some 2-0 and 0-2 teams. You mentioned Arizona, maybe a good surprise. Houston, a bad surprise. Any other teams a surprise at this point to you?
Well, I think that I would look at the Los Angeles Rams right out of the gate at home against Dallas, opening their new stadium. Many thought Dallas would go out west and beat them. That didn't happen. Then how about the Rams going on the road this week and beating Philadelphia and decisively? This looks like a Rams team that finished 9-7 last year. It has designs on challenging for the division title. And one other team I would throw in there is a little bit of a surprise. Just by how it's gone down, how about Atlanta? I know it's tough against Seattle, tough against Dallas. Seattle was at home, but they got jumped on by Seattle. And in the Dallas game, they just gave away. That's a team that should be at worst 1-1 right now. Now looking at 0-2 and have a lot of questions.
15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
On first down, Drake. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
That's exactly what you're looking for at the inside linebacker spot. Versatility. He can drop into coverage, or as he did on that last play, use his speed to get to the perimeter and knock the ball carrier for a loss.
Second and 11. And now Murray's going to set up the throw. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field, it's pumped up in the air, I expect someone to catch, doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
And incomplete. incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Shotgun now for Murray. This is Johnson. He's got it. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. Better than a 30-yard gain as we wind down towards 30 seconds left in the quarter. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. From the gun, it's Drake. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. They'll run with Drake. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
From the 4, it's second and a couple. They run toss to the right with Dre. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2.
And it's 3rd down.
The Cardinals on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. Out of the gun, here's Murray. And Hopkins has got it. Touchdown, Arizona.
Number 10, DeAndre Hopkins.
DeAndre Hopkins. 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And the Cardinals have broken the tie. And it's good. That makes it a 28-21 game.
The score, Cardinals 28, Ravens 21. Zane Gonzalez.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep.
The Ravens take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And now they'll look to answer working from behind. And remember, this offense has sputtered yet to score here in the second half. They'll need to change that here. The drive starts here with a carry by Ingram. And he's going to be stacked up right at the line of scrimmage. Nothing there for him. 2nd down.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again 2nd and 10. Operating from the gun, Jackson. Caught by Snead over the middle. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 12 yards there and a 1st down. You know, Lamar Jackson last season, the first NFL quarterback with 3,000 or more passing yards and 1,000 or more rushing yards in the same season.
And we've seen both of those talents on display here today. We just saw another completed pass. And everyone knew coming out of college he could run the ball.
But for some reason, we didn't analyze the throwing the way we should have. I think every time he completes a pass, he says to himself, take that, evaluators. You guys really missed the boat on me.
They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Looking to throw again on second down. Jackson. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4 yard pickup leaves him with third and one.
It's a gain of four.
This is third and two. Maybe the biggest play in this football game. And he's got the first down. Yardage before being taken down at midfield.
That's good.
They had yet to run the ball at all on this drive, but third and short. Definitely was a great time to dial one up.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Jackson hit, and he lost the football. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down the wire. Back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. This is caught inside the 15. And he gets this down deep inside of Arizona's 15-yard line. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively they burn it here with 1:51 left. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Here's Jackson. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game.
Now, how about that? Rattled by a big play on the previous snap, they bounced back, and that's exactly what they needed defensively, getting a big play of their own.
Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Jackson to throw. That's complete to his running back, J.K. Dobbins. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. Give him three on the screen. He couldn't break free, and it's third down.
I thought that wasn't a bad time to call the screen. I thought late game, down on the scoreboard, had to figure they were expecting a pass downfield.
Yeah, so the edge rushers, they're coming. That could have hit big. You're right. Good recognition defensively to snuff that one out. Jackson to the goal line, but it's incomplete.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
Down seven, and they've got to go for it here on fourth down. Now Jackson. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Jordan Phillips. And that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. Well, their first fourth down attempt earlier was successful. This one backfires for a turnover on downs.
I like their aggressiveness. I like what they're doing. They got it the first time they went for it. Why not a second time? I don't think they'll be daunted from attempting it again. If you're on the defensive side of the ball, though, any fourth down stop is a big momentum play.
Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game.
At the 24-yard line.
Another running situation on the doorstep as they come up second and 10. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as it comes with exactly a minute to go in the football game. The Ravens bring out an extra defensive back here on third. To throw is Murray. And that is incomplete. And this is too far behind his man. He missed him. It's incomplete.
It's no.
Here's Andy Lee now as he'll kick it away for the second time.
For the Cardinals.
A big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt. And the Ravens, they'll take over.
First and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
And they have. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Jordan Phillips in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. He's going to let it fly. And nearly intercepted there. That would have been ball game if he had clinched it and caught it. Instead, it gives him one more chance here on fourth down. They'll look to throw. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off near the 44. And they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line.
At the 45-yard line.
After the turnover, here's Murray going deep for Hopkins. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Anthony Averett picks it, but he will not be able to bring it back. My goodness, what a bizarre ending. The kind of decision that could get a quarterback released before he gets back to the locker room. But fortunately for him and his crew, the ball game is over. But Charles, a one-score game. Down to the end we went. They had one final play in that one-score game. We all knew what was coming, the Hail Mary. They just couldn't get it done.
What exactly complicated was it?
The NFL on EA Sports is in the great state of Tennessee at Nissan Stadium here in Nashville. This crowd here fired up for football as a moment ago their Titans were introduced. This should be a good one as the Titans get set to match up with Russell Wilson and the Seattle Seahawks. Taken in at the three. And good coverage there on special teams as he'll get him down shy of the 20.
At their own 19-yard line.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. That's good for 21 yards and a first down. Opening quarter, his opening carry of the game, and I think they'll give it to him a few more times, as they should.
You're exactly right about that. With that type of a run, you want to repeat it many times until they show signs of stopping it. I think he did his visualization exercise before this one, and they're paying off.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. Wilson after the play fake to Carson. Being chased out left. He lets it fly for Lockett. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. They may have thrown the interception, obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared. But I'm with you. Okay, so it didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. On the ground, this is Derrick Henry. And able to find a little space, he gets us up over the 15 to the 16. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
It's a pickup.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. Tannehill going to turn and give this to Henry. And that closed up quickly there as he gets it up only to about the 17. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
It'll be a nickel look here for the Seahawks on third down. Out of the gun, Tannehill. He's got Evans. And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22. The gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
First and 10 at the 22-yard line.
For Henry. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 17 yards on that play for the Titans.
I remember watching Derrick Henry come out of Alabama and sitting with some scouts, and one of the debate points with him was, while at Bama, how often did he have to deal with contact near the line of scrimmage? They were so good up front that he often got to the second level pretty easily. I think he's starting to answer those questions with runs like that. He's a physical guy.
On first down, it's Tannehill. And that is incomplete. Jonnu Smith, the tight end, is intended receiver. And it's second down.
I'm looking at this with my defensive eyeglasses on because you remember the old days when a tight end saw a linebacker covering him and thought he had a mismatch? But the way they can run nowadays, not necessarily so. They gave it a shot downfield. That one incomplete.
On second down, it's Henry. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. They get six. That'll leave him with third and four.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Third and four.
From the gun on third down, Tannehill trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 39, and they will take over possession of the football at their 42-yard line. So a pretty shaky start here for both sides.
Yeah, each quarterback's throwing a ball to the other team. Do you think on both sidelines they're sitting them down and saying, okay, remember, this is the color jersey we're wearing. They're wearing the other color. Let's make sure we get it to our guys, please.
And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight.
2 yards.
That was a pretty good job defensively to hold him to a 2-yard run. But I've got to think this offensive line, they're asking their quarterback for a different type of a run. One that they rely on, one they have confidence in, one they feel like they can block.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Now Wilson. That's going to be caught by Nick Ballore.
Wilson's pass.
They'll give him eight on the play, and they'll be faced with a third and inches.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks. But it doesn't matter what you call the position, it's who you put there, and there we saw a completion.
And he will have the first down as he gets this to the 47. 2 yards and able to get the first down in the process. Well, throw on first down with Wilson. On the move to his left. Oh, he just needed to throw it away, but instead, out of bounds he goes, and that's a sack. That's going to go as a loss of seven, and it'll set him back for second down. Wilson. That's complete to DK Metcalf. There he goes, right side. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle.
Touchdown.
DK Metcalf, 54 yards. And the Seahawks have taken a first quarter lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Jason Myers to kick off for Seattle.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And it'll come out to the
Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line.